So test case reduction is the process of taking some large input that triggers a failure and turning it into a small input. And it's usually the case that many bugs can be triggered by small inputs. But on the other hand, it's often the case that, for example, we discover a Firefox crash, and the web page that causes the Firefox crash might be giant. It's probably huge. We discover this bug in the wild, and statistically speaking, the pattern in this input that triggers the Firefox crash just probably isn't going to be found in some small web page. So what we can do is, by hand, figure out what part of the input causes the test case. So one thing we can do is eliminate part of the input. And sometimes we do this in a smart way. For example, we might just know that some part of it is unlikely to trigger a crash, or we might just chop some of it out blindly and see if the smaller input triggers the test case. If it doesn't, then we go back to our original test case and try again. If it does, we proceed. So now maybe it's this part. And if we're really lucky, at the very end of this process, we'll end up with a really small test case. And that's the thing we'd like to report to the people developing the software under test. And of course, even if we're not reporting bugs to someone else, that is to say, we're finding bugs in software that we wrote, it's still really nice to have a minimized test case because these make it much easier to track down failure. So option one, manual reduction. This has been done by people debugging for probably about as long as computer science has been around. The second option is really cool. It's a really, really nice technique. It's called delta debugging, and it automates this process. So if you can write a program that can tell automatically if a particular input triggers a failure, that is to say, you load up the web page in Firefox and you'll see if it crashes by looking at the exit code that it provides to the operating system, then delta debugging is a framework that takes your script and takes the test input and automates this process in a loop, and this loop terminates when the delta debugger, which has a bunch of heuristics built in for eliminating parts of the input, it terminates when this delta debugger can't reduce the input anymore. And so what I don't want to do is go into this technique in a ton of detail, because the guy who developed delta debugging is going to be teaching Udacity class sometime soon, and it's probably going to be really interesting. And what I hope is that I've intrigued you enough that you'll really seriously consider taking his class. It's going to be about debugging. What I'd rather do now is show you an example.